Okay, so hi, today we are going to learn from 5.3.2 environment pollution. And last video, we talked about carbon pollution. Basically, I feel the new syllabus, because this is the new syllabus I'm teaching, I think it's slightly difficult. It's difficult for students because it's difficult for the teacher because it's new, so the teacher need to learn. And usually the teacher become very good in teaching if the teacher keep on repeating, but it's new lah, you're always the new batch, so the teacher also blah blah blah. Sometimes I teach also like so can you imagine what the student will be like, what are you talking about? Okay, environment pollution. Type of sources of environment pollution. I think every year we learn this lah, environment pollution. And we really learn air pollution, we know, because Malaysia, who don't know air pollution? Water pollution, I think we know. Land pollution, my student just throw rubbish. I mean, yesterday, I got one student throw rubbish in the compound. And he said in the class, why I don't understand people throw rubbish? Then my teacher go and take picture. This is your rubbish. Then he got nothing to say. Now got the camera, very good lah. Can take picture, people throw rubbish. You say in the class don't throw rubbish, but I got picture of you throwing rubbish. And this is something new. Thermal pollution. What do you mean by thermal? So what is thermal? Like thermometer. Thermometer. Meter is like measure, ther is like temperature. Temperature is temperature, so start from T, but not TH, but TM, temperature. Thermometer, thermostat. Thermostat is the aircon remote control, okay? So it's referring to the heat pollution. I just want to look at the heat pollution. Why got heat pollution? For example, like we can see here, deforestation, industrial activity, fuel combustion and vehicle machine that's causing thermal pollution, especially in the city, correct or not? Because in the city, you can see that here you put building, like Kuala Lumpur, here you put. Put building, never mind. You somehow put the building with glass. So here got all the glass. Then the sun come up, then the heat reflected until here also burn, got fire burn. Try to stand here in the city where all the buildings. So that is why the city now, I hope they are smart. That's why they plant the fountain, water fountain, got water one. That's why you see the KL, sometimes the roundabout, they want to put some fountain water so that it can reduce the thermal heat pollution. But we don't say heat pollution, we call it thermal pollution. I still remember last time I saw a video, like there is a building, a glass building, but the building is curved, something like this. So when the sun rises, and the sun, you know, and because the building is curved, it just generates the heat to a certain spot. And then here always burn. I forget, you park car here means your car will burn. If you put your thing, whatever here, it will start to burn or melt because the building is curved like that. Then I forgot they changed the design because this building design cannot be used. That's why we see people now seldom do building like this. You don't want to do your building like that, like a curve, then the sun come, then you want to burn people down here. So, yep, this is a failure in engineering. As we all know, air pollution is quite common, correct or not? Because we got our neighbor country like Indonesia, they like to produce all the gas and give to Singapore and Malaysia. And natural pollution is natural. Natural pollution is okay. Volcano, forest fire. Forest fire is Usually seldom. It's engineer is human. Human, you smoke, then you throw, then become forest fire. In terms of natural, it rarely happen. Dust storm, decay of organic waste. Man-made, yes, I think man-made is more like exhaust gas from the car, blast furnace. Blast furnace is blast furnace is what really? Blast furnace is to make the metal. How to make the metal? I wonder how the make. Where does metal come from? Metal come from rock and stone. So you take all the rock and the stone, you burn it, you melt it with some chemical. Then the stone, the one you throw away, and the metal accumulated, you get the metal. So, but when you burn it, it's in the blast furnace, and it produces a lot of heat and air pollution. Thermal power station, again, power station. You know lah, power station lah, to make electric. Industrial and garbage disposal site. Okay, so all this cause air pollution. Water pollution, I don't want to go too deep into it lah. I think you all know, okay? Wastewater is the poo-poo and shishi water. Okay? Domestic waste is the like detergent and sewage, like the soap. You put Dynamo, you put a grease into your washing machine, and then the washing machine grow, and then the soap go to the water, go to the longkang, then but if go to the longkang, go to silver, okay, if go to the fish there, I think the fish will die. Solid waste, rubbish, you know already. Industrial waste like grease. Grease the oil lah, you put in the door or car, the grease. Chemical substance used in the agriculture set as fertilizer and pesticide. Fertilizer is 肥料. You want the tree to become fat, so you put a lot of fertilizer. Oh, my pen. And pesticide is the thing that you spray to kill the so that the insect won't eat. The problem is you put then you're very happy. Yeah, I got very beautiful orange mango, but one day it will rain, groom, rain. After rain, they will carry all the fertilizer and the pesticide to the river. The fish will eat the pesticide and we eat the fish, then the next 10 years we have cancer and we die prematurely. So makes sense. Like the food web thing. At last it end up in human. We only think about ourselves, but it come back to ourselves. The more we pollute the environment, it come back to us. Like you pollute, then your grandchildren will take it. But when you grow old already, you feel sad because your grandchildren die faster than you. So it comes back to us. Land pollution. Excessive use of fertilizer is same. It depends, it will might increase the acidity of the soil. And if you put too much fertilizer, the land is polluted, like too acidic. Inappropriate management of solid waste, simply throw rubbish. Sometimes also I throw rubbish, but I throw in the rubbish bin. But sometimes there's no rubbish bin. I mean, not the small, the big rubbish. I don't know who take my big rubbish, the metal big rubbish bin. One day I want to throw. I don't know where they put that thing. So, acid rain, you know lah, acid rain. Why acid rain happen? If you just a little bit of recap, acid rain happen because there's industrial. They produce a lot of gas. You produce all the bad gas in the Shah Alam, for example. I think Seremban, KL less lah. It's more towards industrial site like Shah Alam and Penang. All the factory produce the smoke. So the smoke will go up, then mix with the cloud and then rain. It become an acid rain. Nuclear waste. Malaysia start to have nuclear already. Many people don't support it. And the last one is the electronic waste. Okay, so that's it for this video. I'll make it brief and I will continue it in the next video. Thank you and bye-bye.